open quantum physics. This sounds nice, but conversion of environmental heat into usable energy? This is strange. It sounds as a violation of principle 2 of thermodynamics. Of course, new physics could mean new phenomena, but a violation of a principle which for 200 years stayed as a guard of our thinking, isn't it too much? We shall see. About this is only the last chapter of the book, chapter 9. It is a semiconductor device. This is okay because it means a proper fabrication in a well-known technology. It is based on three fundamental phenomena: superradiance, a really usable energy; Peltier effect, a well-known process for heat absorption from environment; dissipation. This is for the superradiant transitions, for the superradiant field, and for the injected current. Then, the operation principle seems to be clear. While a current is injected in the device, the heat absorbed from the environment by Peltier effect is given back, not by heat as in conventional Peltier devices, but as a coherent electromagnetic energy, usable energy. However, this interesting process, isn't it overwhelmed by dissipation? Is it possible with high efficiency, a higher superradiant power than the electric power consumed for the injection current? This is the big problem. This is the open quantum physics dealing with dissipation, which here intervened in a decisive way. In this book, we proceed to a review of the big theoretical ideas and develop new theoretical methods. In conclusion, this book is a review of famous physical and mathematical ideas for studying realistic systems, a presentation of a new microscopic theory of open quantum systems, and an application of this theory to a very interesting device for the energy production from environment.